Pretty close. 1880.
Yeah, there.
Pretty close. Something I do also is I lean it, burn the plugs off.
Oh, okay, yeah.
These things, this particular engine, the 540 tends to foul plugs a little bit.
Oh, okay.
Some point, but she's running as pretty as a peach. Okay, go ahead and pull that to you.
Here.
Yep. And then flip that lever up the top. It's kind of hard too, by the way. It's a little on the difficult side. It's brand new door seals.
There we go.
So we're good in here. Yep. Here, back door.
Back door's latched.
Okay. Well, we got vacuum.
Actually, the top latch is not latched.
Oh, we need that. Well,
I'll get it real quick.
Need that top latch last. Thank you. Oh, that's good. Overboost. All those are in. Alternate air check. Here's something else you'll learn to do. There's a little deal back here. It just cleans any crap that happens to be in your manifold traffic. Pressure gauge.
Arrow 9091 Yankee is 8 miles south, inbound okay. For runway 32, Cox Beach.
28, 27, 29. Looks good.
All in the green.
Green. Temperature and pressure check. I like to get it up here around about 175.
Okay.
Fuel pressure check. 200 panel check. Ammeter. Kind of high. Air conditioner off.
Yep, off.
Throttle, circuit breakers, fuel pump off, fuel pressure check. Blast off! Now, see if I can do this the right way.
Can you put the approaches into here?
Yeah.
Okay, that's cool.
Cambridge traffic, Saratoga 8331 uniform, taking the active 33 straight out departure, Cambridgeton. Come on, turn. Try not to use the brakes much.
Yeah.
And then you power torque these. I don't know how he teaches you in the 172, but this one, you run the power up before you release the brakes.
Oh, dear.
Same way in a King area, you want all you got,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah, I think the only time I've done that is like short field takeoff.
Yeah. And 172 is not really like necessary because it has such a low rate of rotation. But,
yeah.
But, no, this one, I need 80 knots. I think it's heavy and full of fuel. It's a different story. You want every inch you can.
Yeah.
Every foot, whatever. Okay. One more time. You'll start dancing about 75 knots.
Yeah. Up. Arrow 9091 Yankee, 4 mile final for runway 32, Osage Beach.
Ain't gonna do nothing till we get 500 feet.
You already put the gear up?
Yep, gear's up. I'm backing off the power a little bit here.
Okay.
But I don't wanna overdo it. I backed it off too much. About 32 inches, something like that. Okay, we're pretty close to 500 feet.
Yeah.
Take that out. Autopilot on. We're gonna back to 2,500 RPM. Ease this back. 28 inches. And we're gonna tell it that we wanna go to 3,000 feet. It'll actually climb 3,000 feet for us.
Okay.
Yep. We're gonna go that. We're gonna go 400 feet per minute. And it's gonna shove the nose down.
Yeah.
I wanna get better airspeed. I'm like this. So the cylinders stay cool. Jets, you don't have to worry about any of this shit. I love them.
On what?
Jets, you don't have to worry about any of this cooling, rocking. Damn.
Yeah.
They don't make no difference in the jet.
Yeah.
Come on. There's my altitude. There's my target.
Okay, yeah.
How many feet per minute I'm climbing, which is over there, too. About, I told it.
Yeah, I'm watching.
I told it 400. Let's say 500. And my airspeed coming up now. It'll start climbing more and more. As you climb in one of these, you'll lose manifold pressure. So there's your percent of horsepower.
Okay.
I'm starting to build up a little bit more airspeed in my climbs. Keep these little puppies all nice and cool.
Yeah.
So now I'm going to go nav. And I'm going to move this 20 degrees, which would be 310. 20 degrees. This will be our intercept for our teardrop.
Intercept for what?
Teardrop. We're going to teardrop into this to turn around and come back.
Okay.
Land. Okay. I'm not flying it. Autopilot's flying it.
Right, that's cool.
I can't fly.
Cam is driving Delta 6 Echo Bravo 2.5 south inbound for all 33 Canada.
I think that's the ultralight.
Yeah, where's these fucking clouds come from? I didn't see them earlier.
Yeah, I don't know.
We may not do that because I'm not. If I climb a little higher, I'm gonna be in these sons of bitches.
Yeah. Well, we're pretty much level with them over here.
We'll see. See what we get. Remember, no clouds. I didn't see a cloud in the sky when I left this morning.
I didn't either, man. I was watching, too.
Here's traffic right there. There's your towers. That's something. That's 1,800 feet below us. Probably the ultralight.
Oh, okay, yeah, probably. He was 2.5 miles away.
Yeah, we're going to go back to about...
So that's altitude below you, 1,900?
Yeah, we should start leveling off if I don't get any fucking clouds. I don't have no problem with clouds. It's if I'm not in final flight plan to do that.
Right.
09091 Yankee, clear the active. Off the beach.
All right, we're going to bring our pressures back, our RPMs. Everything's done at 2,300 on this dude. Bring our fuel back. Where we're getting, too much.
Canvas is driving Delta 6 Echo Bravo, 1 mile final, 33 Canvas.
Yep, I don't like this. Heading. Nope, we're not going to do that. We'll just go for a plane ride, I guess. Right. We'll go south.
Yeah, south looks clear.
It's a standard rate turn.
Okay.
So autopilot knows to fly.
That's awesome.
And we've got 25 inches giving us that. We've got 16 gallons.
So is that about normal for cruise, 25 inches?
Well, it just depends on what altitude you're at.
Okay. That's amazing how quick clouds can sneak up on you.
Oh, it is.
Wow.
Okay, let's do this.
Gonna fly the approach for 3-3 now?
Yeah.
Cool.
Get out of these clouds. Now it's gonna go chase it around for a little bit.
Yeah.
So
it just flew over my house, that's cool.
Out of these damn clouds. We were almost to Lori, but oh well.
Yeah.
Ground speed is what? Ground speed is 148 knots right now. It's right there, 149.
Oh, okay, I got you.
I'm gonna ease back. We're in no hurry, you know, since burning a whole bunch of gas for nothing.
17.6.
Yeah. Pull it back about, for approach purposes, about 21 inches. No sense of going super fast. Cabin traffic, Saratoga 3-1 uniform. We are south flying heading 330, head departing to the south, Hampton. Something like that. How's that?
Yeah.
I don't see that ultralight, but whatever.
Yeah, he was on a 1 mile final. I'm sure he's on the ground now. I didn't hear anything after that.
Well, we'll go down to Lebanon.
All right.
These are basically approach settings. What basically is what I'm trying to. You slow everything up. You don't need it any faster than what you need it. Now, King Air, you know, you're doing about 190 knots.
Yeah.
This thing we're doing about 130 knots.
Yeah.
You land it over the fence, 120.
Oh, the King Air. Yeah.
But nice thing about the King Air is. Once you get those power, you never take the power off until the wheels touch, because the jet engines spool. They're slow to climb and slow to fall. So
yeah.
you never do any. This is instant power. They're not.
Right.
What you do is you get the wheels in the ground, you pull up and back. And it pushes, you know.
It changes
the angle of the blades and pushes you for a brake.
Oh.
Otherwise, okay. if you didn't have that, you'd run off the end of the runway. If that breaks, you're in trouble.
Yeah.
We'll fly over here to get off here.
So, we need a 20 degree cut, 30, 150, we need a 20 degree cut, and this is...
I got it on 3-3 now.
3-3, and is getting a 335, so we need 315, excuse me, outbound heading. 155, it would be 130, would be about a 20 degree cut. What I'm going to do is we're going down here. We're going to make it this. We're going to do a teardrop. We're not going to do this. We're going to go cut across here.
Yeah.
Just teardrop back here like a little teardrop shape.
Okay.
At least we think we are anyway. How's that?
Yeah.
We got a ways to go. OTEEN is your initial approach fix.
Okay.
It's just a waypoint. We're going to enter it like this.
Okay.
Turn around and then. When I get to that, I'm going to go to heading, because it won't fly the teardrop. I'm going to teardrop it around with the heading bug, then we'll go back to nav.
Okay.
Right now we're doing about 120 knots, 119.
Yeah.
Indicated, that's good. All that looks pretty. Most important, all that looks good.
Yeah.
While I'm doing it, I'm going to go ahead and suck off that right tank a little bit.
I'm on.
Fuel boost on. Nothing's happening, nothing bad. Fuel boost off. And we'll just come in and shoot the approach. If I don't fuck it up, we'll shoot the approach and just land.
Okay. That doesn't show anything on weather.
No, we should be in good
shape.
Just
clouds, I guess.
Some clouds just popped up. This thing will kind of talk to you, too. Now, you can tell it, VSR means velocity, speed required.
Okay.
You can tell it, you can go in here and tell it, I'm not going to do it because we're doing the glide slope.
Yeah.
You can tell it, let's say you're 50 miles from your destination, you're at 12,000 feet. This will tell you, it'll throw up a number of what your descent rate is. As it starts getting around 500, and you know you need to make your descent, get permission, of course.
Yeah.
Make your descent, this will actually calculate how many feet per minute you can dial in, either do it by hand or by, which I use that.
Yeah.
I just use the autopilot, but.
Yeah, autopilot's nice.
Yeah, it is.
Sweet.
No autopilot all last week. In that sim, no autopilot.
Oh, yeah.
No autopilot.
All hand flying?
All hand flying. In the clouds, in the storm, in the rain, lost engines, lost engine on takeoff, lost.
Yeah.
Every kind of crazy fucking thing you can imagine they throw at you.
Were they like 8-hour days?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no shit.
Oh, yeah, about 30-minute break for lunch or a pee break if you needed one.
But yeah.
I basically said, I don't want to take a break. Let's just keep this, get it done. Let's get it over with.
Did you fly this down there?
No, I didn't. I thought that Corey was going to need it. I made a deal with Corey, but he needs to go to Dallas for his airline stuff.
Yeah.
He needs to get there quick. He thought he might need it, and I bought tickets on Allegiant Air. $98 one way.
Holy shit.
Well, 98 times two, but
yeah.
For me and my wife, I mean, I can't. This is going to cost more than that.
Hell yeah.
What we're doing right now.
Yeah.
I thought, well, hell, that way, you know, if the weather does get bad, Florida has funky weather. If it gets bad, I don't want to be late getting into school.
Yeah.
And then I don't want to be stranded there, you know. And can't beat, you know, $198 a ticket.
Yeah, no kidding. Where did you fly out of?
Springfield.
Did you?
There's your CDI here, and this acts like a CDI,
you know,
too.
It's open, I believe, too.
But that's later.
Yeah.
So we're going to fly. See how it's drawing this?
Yeah.
It's starting to draw it out now.